introduce yourself.
I am Amit Kumar Maharana. I completed my BTech in 2017 and MTech in 2021. As there is more opportunities and growth plus salary wise in IT sector, I decided to switch my domain from mechanical to IT. So I'm currently right now I'm pursuing automation testing in GrowTech Minds.
Okay, explain what is public static void main string arguments.
Sir, it is the main method. It is the only executable part of the program. When we go for public, public is the access specifier. Static is the modifier. Void is the return type, and main is the method name. Plus arguments are provided as string arguments. It can be parameterized or non-parameterized in nature types.
Okay, what is method overloading?
Sir, developing multiple method with same name but different argument list is called method overloading. Example, add when there is no arguments, and second one is add when we provide argument as int a or string anything. We can change the arguments accordingly.
And what are the conditional statements?
Sir, conditional statements are the if else if nested if else. These are the four conditional statements. In if, we provide one condition. If it is true, it goes inside the block. If it false, it exits. But in if else, if we condition is true, it goes the if blocks. But if condition is false, it goes to the else block. And similarly, in if else, we provide multiple conditions. And in nested if else, if under if else, there is another if else blocks, and so on.
Okay, what are the comparison operators?
The comparison operator, first one is the AND operator, the second is OR, and the third is NOT. In AND operator, it is required to satisfy both of the conditions to get in the AND block. But in OR operator, any one of the condition can be true to execute. And in the Boolean expression is reverse. That is, if it is true, it will reverse as false. And if it's false, it is reverse as true.
Okay, so what is constructor?
The constructor is a special type of method which has the same name as that of the class. It is a kind of non-static in nature, and it can have all four of the access specifier.
Explain constructor overloading.
Sir, constructor overloading means we are developing multiple constructor with a different argument list. That is, the constructor name is same as the class, but we are providing arguments differently in each of the constructor.
So what is the inheritance, and explain all the types of inheritance?
Starting with inheritance. Inheritance is the property of a child class to inherit the property of parent class. And types, first is single level inheritance, second is multi-level, third is multiple level, fourth is hierarchical, and fifth is hybrid. So starting from single level, the one child is present and one parent class is present. The one child inherit the properties of one parent. In multi-level, there is one child class, one parent class, and one supermost class. That is, the child class will inherit the property of parent class, and the parent class will inherit the property of supermost class. In going with multiple level, there are many parents. That is, parent can be more, but only one child class that will inherit the property of two or more parent classes. This is not possible in the case of abstract class, but we can achieve it with interface. And fourth is hierarchical level. In there, only one parent class is present, and there can be more than two child class, which inherit the properties of parent. And lastly, hybrid. In hybrid, it is a combination of a single, multi, and hierarchical level inheritance.
Okay, what is method overriding?
Sir, in method overriding, a method is developed in the parent class, which has the same name and signature as that of the child class, but with different implementation. The method body is different.
Okay, what is super keyword?
Sir, super keyword is only used in the concept of method overriding. In a super keyword, we get the parent class implementation together with the child class implementation.
Okay. What is super calling statement?
Super calling statement is used when we call parent class constructor from the child class constructor. It can be of parameterized or non-parameterized in nature. For parameterized, we have to call explicitly. And for non-parameterized, we can call explicitly as well as implicitly.
Okay. So what is difference between local and global variable?
So local variable, it is defined under a method. The scope of the method is, sorry, the scope of the variable is from starting of the method to the end of the method. The local variable does not have any default values. And the local variable cannot be distinguished between static and non-static. For global variable, it is defined under a class but outside any method. That is, the scope of the global variable is from start of the class to the end of the class. And the global variables have default values. For example, for int, byte, short, and long, the default values are 0. For the double and float, it's 0.0. For character, it is not defined. For boolean, it is false. For string, it is null. And lastly, the global variables can be distinguished between non-static and static nature.
Okay, what is this keyword?
Sir, this keyword, it is used to assign the value of the local variable to the global variable. It is only possible in the to do it in the non-static method only. And when the method variable are same as that of the global variables declared.
What is this calling statement?
Sir, this calling statement is when we call one constructor from another constructor within the same class. We use this calling statement.
Okay. What is scanner?
The scanner is scanner is a Java final class in which we take the runtime input from the user. Example are next int, next byte, next long. With this, we can take integer type inputs.
Okay, so what exception we get in scanner?
In scanner, we get input mismatch exception. When we input anything other than the provided example, if we had to input integer, we have to input integer. We can't input any character or string.
Okay, so what is abstract class and abstract method?
Sir, abstract class is a class which consists of both abstract method as well as abstract concrete method. In abstract class, we can achieve abstraction from 0 to 100%. Abstract class with abstract class, we cannot achieve the concept of multiple level inheritance. And abstract class is defined with the keyword of abstract. Then abstract class can be inherited, can inherit a class with the keyword called extends. And this, and then abstract methods, a method which do not have a implementation or a method body, it is called abstract method.
Okay, so what is the difference between abstract method and concrete method?
Abstract method are methods which doesn't have a body, but concrete method are the method which have the body. And abstract method are needs to be overridden in the child class.
Okay. So what is implements?
So implements is used when we inherit the interface.
Okay. So explain interface.
Sir, interface is a it has only abstract method. Okay, then we can achieve 100% abstraction through interface. And its access specifier are only public and default. And we use the keyword interface to declare any interface.
Okay, so what is abstraction?
The abstraction is a property of a Java where we hide the implementation and show only what is required. With interface, we can achieve 100% abstraction. And with abstract class, we can achieve 0 to 100% abstraction.
Okay. What is the access specifier for methods outside the package by becoming the subclass?
By becoming subclass, that would be public and by becoming public and default, I guess. Public and there are four parts within the method, within class, by I'm not remembering, sir. I think it's public and one more. I would like to skip there.
Okay. So what is a string functions? Just mention the string functions we use.
We can use dot length to get the length of the string, a character at index to get any character at a certain index, to upper to convert the string into uppercase, to lower to convert the string into lowercase, trim, we use trim to delete the spaces starting or in last of the string. These are some examples.
Okay, what is exceptional handling?
Sir, when an exception occurs in a program, the program then and there stops. To control this, we use try and catch block. We write the exception in the try block and and write the handle in the catch block. If an exception occurs, the catch block will execute and try blocks will not execute. If the exception do not occur, the try block will execute and the catch block will not execute. And
What is the difference between throw and throws?
Sir, a throw is defined under a method and it is used to throw any exception. With one throw, we can only throw one exception. But the throws, it is used together with the method name. It is used to declare any exception. With one throws, we can declare many exceptions.
What is a typecasting and explain all the typecasting?
Typecasting, sir, means converting one type to another type. The types are first is the primitive typecasting and second is class typecasting. In primitive typecasting, it is narrowing and widening. Primitive typecasting means converting one data type to another data type. In narrowing, we convert larger data type to smaller data types. In widening, we convert smaller data types into larger data types. And then class typecasting, we convert one class to another class. That is, one type is upcasting. Upcasting, we convert the subclass object to a superclass object. And is in downcasting, we convert the superclass object to subclass object. To do downcasting, we have to do upcasting.
Okay, what is array?
So array, in array, we store homogeneous element together. An array has only finite size, and array can store null values.
What is collection?
A collection, sir, it is an interface in nature. A collection is a framework where there are many types of interfaces and classes within it. A collection, within collections, we have set, list, and queue. These are the interface, and within this, in set, we have reset, hash set, and links hash set. In queue, we have priority queue, and in list, we have array list, link list, and vectors.
What is encapsulation?
Sir, encapsulation means, firstly, we restricting the data member, that is the variable and the method, by using access specifier. For example, we have to restrict a variable by making it access specifier private. We can control it by using the getter and set method. With setter, we can set the value of the variable. From get, we can get the value or return the value.
Okay, what is polymorphism?
Polymorphism is the element, that is the object, will show different behavior in different stages of its life cycle. That is, the object will behave differently in different period of its time. Its types are runtime polymorphism and compile time polymorphism. In compile time, it shows different behavior in different stages of life cycle based upon the argument passed. An example is method overloading. And in runtime, it is showing different behavior in different stages of life cycle based upon the object created. And the example is method overriding.
Okay, write a program in scanner and show the exception in console.
Sir, my screen is visible?
Yes, it is visible.
input mismatch exception.
Okay, handle this exception using try and catch. And write another program where there will be two SIBs, two constructors,
so 1 minute,
and two IABs.
Two SIB,
then two constructors. Then two IABs. Then so it's order of execution in console.
Yes. Sir, firstly, the SIB will execute, then the main method, then IRB, then constructor. In this case, the firstly the SIB executed, and as soon as we created the object, IRB executed, then the first constructor. And when we created the second object with the parameter, it called another, again IIBs, then the second constructor.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay, shall I close the sharing?
Yeah.
Okay, Amit, thank you. You have answered perfectly many questions. Just that one error you did, that I asked about comparison operator. Actually, it should be greater than equal to. Is that thing.
Sorry.
You answered about that logical operators.
Yeah.
And one thing, access specifier for methods outside the package by becoming the subclass, it should be public and protected.
Richard, yes.
This thing. Otherwise, everything is good.
Okay. I have to
Thank
revise
you.
Them.
Thank
you, sir. Thank you for the.